Bikes have always been a huge part of my family. In fact, I could even say I was born on a bike. Over the years, my garage has grown, unfortunately not in size. My garage has grown in bike parts and bikes. As we add newer and newer bike parts every year, I enjoyed tampering and riding all these bikes. Throughout San Francisco, bicycle messengers have ruled the streets. Not caring for traffic signals, running red lights, and creating havoc, these honorable citizens of America are my idols. Yeah, they don't sound very honorable. But these men go out every day to risk their lives, deliver messages, and save their environment by riding bikes. The start to the bicycle began in 1817 by a German inventor named Baron von Drais. He used this machine called the walking machine to help him get around faster. Unfortunately, it was not a very effective use of energy, and it was not popular for a very long time.
The next invention was the velocipede, also known as the bone shaker. It was invented in 1865 and had pedals attached to the front wheel. It was made of entirely wood, and it was not very comfortable. That's why it was called the bone shaker.
The pedals, however, are the start to the modern-day bicycle because they exert force more efficiently.
The next bicycle is credited today as the first bicycle. It is a high-wheel bicycle. It was invented in 1870 and consisted of all metal parts. This helped make it more comfortable. It had pedals attached to the front wheel. It also had long spokes that made riding smoother.
Many inventors over the years helped progress the bicycle, even though some didn't even know that Leonardo da Vinci made the cog and chain idea in the 15th century, and 400 years later it was put into the bike's design. Another man named Paul Delevingne also helped invent many things for the bicycle. He tested many gearing ways and in 1905 tested a two-speed derailleur. In 1933, Tullio Campagnolo had perfected and produced the derailleur system. As I climb this hill, I am using a certain type of force. That force is work. The definition of work is using force to move an object. In here, I am moving the bike by exerting force on the pedals to turn the cranks so that I can go higher at the hill. Another key element of the bicycle is friction. Friction is a force that resists the motion of objects or surfaces. Friction is found in many parts of the bicycle, like the tires, which help you stay on the road. It's also decreased in other parts of the bicycle, like the hubs.
If you look closely inside the hub, you can see little tiny balls. These are ball bearings, which help decrease friction. Without these ball bearings, the wheel would not roll or roll smoothly.
Ball bearings are used in other parts of the bicycle to reduce friction, like in the headset and the cranks.
All bicycles have gears, whether it's one gear or many gears.
When you pedal, you cause the crank arms to turn. Causing the crank arm to turn causes your front gear to turn. When your front gear turns, it reacts to the chain, which allows the chain to turn around, moving back to your back gear. When your back gear turns, you're spinning the back hub, which pushes you forward. Here I am using work to ride the bike and friction to stay on the path.
If you look closely at the derailleur, the small thing with the little wheel at the bottom, you can see it kind of moving in different ways. That is a sign of shifting the gears. When we shift the gears, we are changing the gear ratio, making it easier or harder to turn. Gear ratios apply to how much work you must put into riding the bicycle.
Many elements and physics concepts of the bicycle have helped progress inventions over the years, especially the bicycle. The bicycle is a key example of force, friction, and work.